When we started in India, so the first market that we looked at is our own home country, and we scaled there. We saw our first 1 million users, then we saw our first 10 million users. So between the 1 million and 10 million is when we knew that we needed to go global, and people were already querying of being able to see the content from their own space. So the first easy market or easy audience that you can grab is Indians outside India, the Indian diaspora. So actually, Indians outside India are more hungry for the Indian content than the Indians themselves are. So we got a lot of emails, a lot of requests saying that we need it from this place. We still get emails saying for a particular show, particular movie, particular song, they have requests like that coming in. Now, once we did that and we reached out to different countries, to Indians in different countries, we also felt that while this country, let's say Germany, has a lot of audience for us, why don't we also invoke the German content? So then we picked up, so the licensing of content is a very different animal in different countries. India has the most dispersed model of licensing. Everybody can license you the same movie. And surprisingly, our movie can be licensed by 5 people exclusively to you. So you really don't know who's the actual owner. So those are big challenges here. Whereas in international market, in most of the settled down countries, copyrights are taken very seriously and you know you'll get it authentically. But because it is already filtered, cleaned, and narrowed down, the expectations are very different. So initially we used to position as an Indian company doing this business. And we didn't see, unfortunately, very good traction because they all started slapping us an advance payment. And then we started saying that we are a Singaporean company, and then the advance started disappearing. So sometimes credibility also by force, which is not your credibility, it's overall that comes out. Play that when it comes to doing that situation. So when we wanted to go local, I would not say go global, I would say go local to different countries, and that's how you become global. Getting content was a challenge. And then we finally, over hard work of many months and years, we've managed to get content for those regions, for those audiences, which really helped us scale in different manners. So there are, so we have centralized locations. So we have Singapore, we have London, we have shadow office in US. So most of the time we do calls, and we sometimes send somebody to cover up one shot. You go and stay for 2 weeks and cover up everything. Yeah, so because no, we have a physical office, that's used for accounting and other purposes. But the way we operate is the business guys actually go there for a short period, come back.
The people are somewhere else.
Yeah. So, okay. And then physical offices in Delhi, Bombay, Singapore, and Dubai, and okay. London. This is more from where the business is coming or how. So London for European region was the easiest place, and benefits wise they give you quite a good benefit. Dubai is an obvious choice for the UAE region. Singapore is the best region for the Asian market. India, we were anyways present.